imported tables for vendor masters. So to go to vendor master tables, go to SE16N. So you will see here table name. So update the LFA1. So LFA1 basically give you a information of general information of a vendor master. So when I execute this one, this is the execute button, execute this one. So here you will see vendor, these are the vendor details, for which country this vendor is belongs to, name of the vendor, and the city where this vendor is belongs to. All this information you will get it in the LFA1 table, but it is not at extended to company code or not, that you will not come to know in this table. So this is completed at a general view level. So to know whether this vendor is updated at a company code level or not, so what we have to do is we have to go to another table, LFB1. LFB1, enter and execute. So here you will see this particular vendors are being executed to company code or not. So in this table LFB1, so you will come to know vendor, if this vendor is extended to that particular company code or not. So this is how we can check vendor related information using LFB1 and LFA1 transaction codes. So one more thing, sometimes it happens that this is a normal names, company code and all, and these are the technical names. So if you basically the technical people likes a technical name in their field name and everything. So this is the option which we have, change settings, go to change settings, and here we have a fields like a technical column name and field. So the first column we are seeing client, vendor, company code and all. So select this technical details thing and click on save and execute. So if you see first column, you will see the technical names, and the next column you will see the names of the fields. So if I go inside this LFB1 or LFA1, any table, so I can still see the vendor name, company name and all. If I want to change this into a technical names, I will go back here, only we have the settings, change settings option, and click on the technical name as a column heading and save this. Now I will execute this one. So if you see here, the header columns has converted into a technical names columns. So this is how we can change the technical names to a normal naming conversion, or normal naming conversion into a technical names using that fields. And these are the two important vendor master tables which we can use for our reporting or any other purpose.